ऐसा कोई सिचुएशन आपको? हाँ जी,
30 ईयर्स ओल्ड डॉक्यूमेंट
जी,
सेक्शन 90।
नो, नॉट कंटेंट्स, वी आर नॉट टॉकिंग मोड ऑफ प्रूविंग, प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड। 30 ईयर्स डॉक्यूमेंट सेक्शन 90 एविडेंस एक्ट इज एडमिसिबल एविडेंस। You are admitting that document. You are saying the mode of proving is wrong. How will you prove that? Because that document is 30 years old, need not proved. Unless it is rebuttable, because the court is presuming it to be true. Mode of proving ke liye... Haji, bataiye. Last mein you were raising.
Proponent of document is not in existence.
I'm sorry?
Proponent of document is not in existence.
Pro forma.
Propounder
of document. Correct. What's your name?
Mangesh.
Clap for Mangesh. Very good. The document is admissible, par jo propounder hai, wo kahan hai? Proof karne wala. Isko proof kaun kar raha hai? Aur mujhe lag raha hai, sirf Mangesh ne hi meri kahani gaur se suni thi. Harishchandra wali. Aap bhul gaye. पुरुषोत्तम मर गए थे, पुरुषोत्तम का डेक्लेरेशन प्रिवी काउंसिल पे गया था और इट वाज ऑब्जेक्टेड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ प्रूविंग, नॉट द एडमिसिबिलिटी ऑफ द डॉक्यूमेंट। डॉक्यूमेंट वाज ऑथेंटिक बट द मेथड ऑफ प्रूविंग, बिकॉज द प्रोपाउंडर वाज डेड, हु विल प्रूव? राइट, सो थैंक यू मंगेश। नाउ दैट इज हाउ, अगर प्रूविंग ऑफ अ डॉक्यूमेंट पर ऑब्जेक्शन है, देन हेमेंद्र गिया सेज कोर्ट कैन नॉट मूव अहेड, यू हैव टू डिसाइड फर्स्ट, नहीं तो आप एग्जिबिट, ये फिर ये डॉक्यूमेंट एग्जिबिट करके हम क्रॉस एग्जामिन कैसे करेंगे? आप इसको टेंटेटिवली मार्क कर दो, मैं किसको क्रॉस एग्जामिन करूँ? मूड ऑफ प्रूविंग ही नहीं है। टेंटेटिव डॉक्यूमेंट एडमिसिबिलिटी का आप बाद में डिसाइड कर सकते हैं, मोड ऑफ प्रूविंग तुरंत डिसाइड करना पड़ेगा। Another section which is Hemendra Gya's judgment says need to be decided immediately by the court is that if the objection is in respect to the revenue to the government. Revenue to the government means agar document is insufficiently stamped. And if you have raised the objection, sir, this document is not stamped properly, this contract, this agreement, whatever, then the court has to decide immediately. गवर्नमेंट के बारे में देर नहीं कर सकते, तुरंत डिसाइड करो। एंड नॉट ओनली यू हैव टू डिसाइड द एडमिसिबिलिटी ऑफ द डॉक्यूमेंट, इफ इट इज इनसफिशिएंटली स्टैम्प्ड, यू हैव टू इम्पाउंड दैट डॉक्यूमेंट, सेंड इट टू द कलेक्टर टू एडजुडिकेट, गेट द स्टैम्प ड्यूटी पेड इन वन ऑफ द जजमेंट्स इन वन ऑफ द केसेज विच आई हैव बीन हैंडलिंग। वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग स्टोरी, टू साइड्स वर फाइटिंग अबाउट अ प्रॉपर्टी। The plaintiff had entered into an MOU with the seller of the land. 100 रुपए के MOU पर ये डील हुई कि हम ये लैंड आपसे इतने रुपए में खरीदने को तैयार हैं। सेलर ने कहा हम बेचने को तैयार हैं। This MOU happened. During the subsistence of MOU, the seller sold the land to the third party through a registered conveyance deed at a higher price and handed over the possession also. The plaintiff filed the suit stating here is a contract according to which I have to purchase at this price and they have to sell. How could this sale happen to the third party? And therefore, to declare that conveyance deed as null and void. Now, I was engaged by this third party purchaser. So when we went through along with our team and we were researching on these papers, we found that the first document, that MOU, is falling under none of the categories of the contract, because for the specific performance of the contract you must have a contract, and MOU of 100 rupees has a very little evidentiary value as against the registered conveyance deed with full stamp duty paid. So we objected to the court that, sir, the suit needs to be rejected because it is on the basis of an insufficiently stamped document. And immediately on that basis, because as the judgment says that the court has to decide if the document is insufficient, to immediately, they cannot procrastinate. So the document was impounded, sent to the collector. Now this poor guy has to now pay the stamp duty on that MOU to first become entitled to contest the suit. If he says that no, this is duly stamped because this is not a conveyance deed, this is not agreement for sale, it does not need full payment of stamp duty, then the suit goes. And if he pays the stamp duty and loses the suit, he loses a lot of money because this is crores of worth land. So that is how these minutes can help you several times on the point of law. So that is how this Hemendra Gya judgment holds field. It's a wonderful judgment, go through. And it covers a lot of judgment prior to that. Even Amir Trading's judgment has been taken. Salem's Bar Association's judgment is also taken into consideration by that Hemendra Gya judgment. Salem's Advocates Association is a wonderful judgment which talks about that if an evidence is produced under Order 18 Rule 4 on the affidavit before the court, because nowadays examination in chief in most of the civil suits is through affidavit. But along with the affidavit, you have to produce a list of documents also. But then can list of documents produced before the court will be taken by the court into cognizance only on the basis of the affidavit? The Salem's Bar Association's judgment, the Supreme Court has held that no, that does not have that evidentiary value. The person who's producing those list of documents has to prove those documents entering into the witness box. So these are lovely judgments, very enlightening, very clarifying, a lot of confusions there. So to sum it up, before I finish, I'm just summing it up, Please remember, first rule, exhibiting of a document is not proving of a document. So even if a document is marked exhibited, it is not means that it is proved. You have to prove it also, first. Second, the objection in respect of exhibiting can be of two types. Objection in respect of admissibility of a document and objection in respect of the mode of proof of the document. In respect of exhibiting of a document or proving of a document, please feel free to call me. Me, even if I'm not personally available, my office will be readily, happily available to assist you, to guide you, to give you all relevant provisions, because we have developed such a wonderful research team and we have been doing this to assist whatever we could to our bar. It's just a method and it's totally free of cost. There is no expectation. There is no remuneration required from you. You can definitely give a call. You get, provided you are not finding anywhere, you have to simply send your email address. The judgments will be mailed to you from our office. So please feel, whatever we could assist to our bar, we are ready for that. And apart from it, already uploaded on YouTube. So you have to just go on YouTube, type my name, Puneet Chaturvedi Advocate, and you will get all the speeches, even the earlier speech of electronic evidence. It is already uploaded on the YouTube. So you can find those speeches. Apart from that, you'll find speeches on various other laws, Cr.P.C, CPC, company law. And if you want my number, 98210-100-59. I'm Puneet Chaturvedi. You can call me anytime.